Okay, this is your last class before your test. This is the four questions we gave you, just as a final four questions to make sure your brain's in working order. Four questions. The first question actually gives you 2% of numbers. One you have to solve mentally, the other you have to solve with a calculator. So for this first one, it asks you for 16/10% of 420. And really what it wants you to understand is that 60% is really the sum of 50% and 10% and 1/10%. Each of which you should know how to do mentally. So for 50%, that's simply half of a number. So that would be $210. 10%, you simply move the decimal one place. So in $420, you move one place, you get 42. And for 1/10%, that's moving the decimal three places. That's your new learning for grade eight. So if it's here, and you move it 10%, 1%, 1/10%, you would know that 1/10% is 42 cents. So if you add all those together, you get $252.42, which is 60/10%, finding it mentally using the sum of those three. The second one, you're asked to use a calculator, which means you have to translate 13.25% into a decimal. So 13.25% would be 13.25 out of 100, since it's a percent, which would be 1325 over 10,000 if you make an equivalent fraction, which is 13 and 25 10 thousandths, looks like that, of the 126.80. Take your calculator. That's 13.25% of 126.80. Your final answer would be $16.80 with 1/10 of a cent left over. Since you probably have to round it, you would say therefore is approximately 1680. Round it to the nearest cent. In your next question, you have a chart. You're asked to put it as a fraction, decimal, or cent. Remember, every time you're given a fraction, simply take your numerator divided by its denominator. You get the decimal. Once you have that, you can write it as a fraction with a base 10 denominator. And once you have that, you can make an equivalent fraction out of 100, and therefore you can express it as 12.5%. In this next one, you have 108 thousandths, which would be 108 over 1,000, which is your answer. But if it asks you on a test for LT, that means lowest terms, we know for sure that 2 is a factor, which is 54 over 500, which is still divisible by 2, which is 27 over 250. That would be your answer as a lowest term fraction. But really, this is the fraction I'm concerned with, because if I want to get a percentage, I would have 108 thousandths, which is an equivalent fraction out of 100 for the percent, would be 10.8. Therefore, you have 10.8%. And the final question says 125 and a fifth percent. Anytime you have a fraction in your percent, get rid of it. Change a fifth into a decimal. So a fifth is 2/10, and 2/10 is decimal 2, which means these two numbers are the same. Much better to use the second version than the first. Write that as a percentage fraction out of 100 and make it as an equivalent fraction with no decimal in the numerator. And then probably if it's an improper fraction, you should always reconstitute it back into a mixed and then reduce it to lowest terms from there. So that'd be 1 and 126 over 500, which is 1 and 63 over 250. That would be lowest terms. But of all those ones, in order to get it to a decimal, this is the one I'm going to use as a decimal, because that's 1 and 252 thousandths, which is that final answer. Your next question gives you this picture, and I should actually probably draw that little line there, and that should be this red line here. It says, what is this picture representing? So we know that this whole thing would be 100% of something, so it's less than 100%, or it's less than one full block. And really what I have is I have 29% and a little bit more. And if I look here, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10 parts. So it's 29 and a tenth percent, or 29 and a tenth percent. Both of those are the same number. As a, oh, that's a, sorry, that's as a percent. As a fraction, if I think of all of these divided into 10 parts, then that would be, sorry, let's say as a improper fraction that, and as a equivalent fraction, if I was to divide each of these into 10 parts, then the whole thing would have 1,000 of these. 1,000 of those would make up the whole object. And I would have, here would have 100 of these, 100 here, 100 here, or sorry, 90 here. So I'd have 291 of those thousandths, which is why this is an equivalent fraction. And finally, as a decimal, 291 thousandths is 0.291. And your final question is, you're given a scooter that costs $4,840, and you're given a 20 and one-tenth percent discount. Then you have to add on 4 and three-fifths percent tax. How much is your final price? So the first thing I'm going to do is calculate how much the discount is. So 20.1% is 20.1 out of 100, which is 201 over 1,000, which is 20 and a tenth percent. Of that amount, which is 4,840, if I calculate that tax, or that discount, excuse me, so 20 and a tenth percent of the $4,840 scooter, the discount, I'll write it in red, the discount is going to be $972.84. Okay, so I take my scooter, subtract the discount, and the price after the discount, extend this a little bit here. The price after the discount will be $3,867.16. Now, on top of that, I got to then put a 4 and 3/5 percent tax. Now, this 4 and 3/5 is the same thing as 4.6 percent, because 3/5 and 6/10 are the same number. So 4 and 3/5 and 4 and 6/10 would be the same, so this is really the percent. As a fraction, this would be true, but as a better fraction, this would be truer. And since it's 4.6% as a decimal, would be 46 thousandths. So, therefore, 4.6% of the discounted price of the scooter, so multiply that by decimal 046, the amount of tax I'm going to pay is going to be $177.89. Now, I'm going to round that to not 88 cents, because that third decimal place, which is your hundredths of a cent, is going to round that penny up to the nearest penny, which is that. So I'm going to take $177.89 tax, add it to the price of my scooter. Oh, that's not right. There's my tax. Add that to the price of my scooter. And the final price I'm going to pay, the final price is $4,045.05. That's the final price. That would be your answer.